Hello, in this video I decided to do something suicidal. I'm basically trying to record Tyranny playthrough. And we'll see how it goes. Last time I got there, to this Scarlet Horus camp, where Jagged told me to convince Unbroken to join them. Fuck. Okay, I don't have any FPSs while recording. Here basically they talk, we can allow them to continue, or we can interrupt. I wanna see what it's happen when I interrupt. Athletic check. Now this guy leaves. And we are facing only this person for dialogue. My apologies for that. Yeah. So we can now lie to him. You have an ally to Unbroken here. Which is sadly terrible because I don't mind being allied with Unbroken, and here is only lies. So I can either state the truth or lie. I am part of Scarlet Horus, so technically lies are more of a way of my people. Yeah, I can, for example, cry about Scarlet Horus being so fucking great, but honestly, it's better to fucking lie. Let's be honest. This Horus seems to be your only choice. No, that's lame. Four. Five. Joining the Horus is best to reach Sentinel Stand. 2 as lore. Sadly, I don't know what would be required, Matthias. Honestly, I think whenever you see check, you should take them. This gives XP. I'm not sure if any other give. I see what I can do is more respectful. So I will obviously take that option. Because I honestly have no intention in being garbage. We'll see how far in this map I can really go. Here I found some dagger. Relatively good sword. Nothing spectacular. Basically, as you can see, my FPS counters are extreme for recording like this. And for that reason, I'm not sure if I will be able to continue this series. Because as much as I would want to, and as much as my OBS is pretty optimized for this type of recording, my PC can no longer run it and OBS at a decent speed.
Can't do that.
Unbroken. Tell me about regions. Tell me about Unbroken. You are seeing bigger picture joining Scarlet. Yeah, this Scarlet Horus propaganda is kind of trash. Especially since I myself are not exactly top one supporter of Scarlet Horus. I mean, I do this type of playthrough for fun. I mean, I do respect some of the methods Scarlet Horus use much more than this favor. However, holy fucking shit, I had no idea. This feels to be like most evil choice, possibly, or something very, very evil. The unbroken leader might be swayed if you release some of your prisoners. No. Okay, yeah. 5, 6. Okay, how about Ironwork? I'm sure they have fun. Lore is always better checked than subterfuge. Return to Matthias. Okay, I have no new options. Okay, we're going back to Matthias and asking him for joining Horus. I pretty much like this thing because we are at least resolving situation peacefully. Which is a lot. I hate violence and this. You know, strength solution when I am stronger than all these shits. Oh, holy fuck, okay, they are really tormenting this Iron Walker guy. Yeah, grats. Yeah, very, very cool. I'm not sure what I'm fucking doing, really. Lore is probably best. Lore is probably best, but maybe. Never mind. I didn't. This wasn't my intention. Guys, this is just hard, okay? I never know what came out from these dialogues, and ideally, I wanna do it. Nice. Don't get me wrong, I could win this battle, just not easily, and I will be forced to run away temporarily. Or basically sacrifice my main character or something. I'm not sure exactly how I would play it, because this is not easy. Okay, this is before dialogue with this guy. Great, maybe we will be able to convince him to do something else than stupid. Unbroken guys. Matthias pledged to Horus. No. Mean, this is lame as fuck. No. This don't give me any lore, any athletics, any coolness. This is most lame option ever. I'm sorry, I just wanna explore all the options. I know I should probably be checking on Wiki before making any choices in this game, I know. But honestly, I'm curious, like, which option is the best? What are the outcomes? Because you don't know what will be later, and you cannot, like, get back. So, anyway. Yeah, we wanna free. How about just Iron Walker? How about just unbroken prisoners? And here I have a lore for four. And this seems to be best option for me because I'm passing lore check. Maybe athletics would be better. Oh, also, according to my knowledge, in this game, your experience. Is distributed evenly as you level up. So you may always wanna remove abilities related to items you're not using. So in my case, I always use magic staff and I always use one-handed. Which basically means two-handed weapons are useless to me. One-handed bows. Unarmed is also not terrible. One-handed is terrible for Vers since she used two-handed. One-handed are great, dual-wield are not that, is not that great. Unarmed can always happen when enemies disarm you. Yeah, by disabling the skills, level ups will not level them, so your other skills level up. Just make sure magic staff is not disabled. I will not use dual wield in this run, despite having a lot there. Okay, I wanna save. We mostly save because I just don't wanna have it on me later. Like, you know, setting these things. This is extreme. I forget about this, but when you do the quest normally, you get XP in this game. So you wanna get XP distributed towards points you wanna level. We have Lord check. Also, you can like check out how this person is basically approaching me and how I'm making use of this for my advantage. My current frame rate don't allow me to use too advanced tactics. But we will still make good use out of this combat. Lucky this mind spell have range of kilometers. Okay, we have heal aura, that is extremely useful. I'm not sure if I will be able to cast this spell on time. From what I can tell, EB can cast heal. Control Frost, okay? He would have served Horus better alive. It's a pity. One more corpse to step over on our journey to greatness. Does my character have intention to cast this fucking spell or no? No, of course. Okay, they basically agree to join Horus. We convinced a lot of them, maybe not all. Anyway, this is like giant strength of Scarlet Horus. And they allow a lot of recruits.
Sorry, I can't.
Which results in them having giant numbers and growth possibilities and a lot of variable races and cultures. Look at this sexy Scarlet Fury. Okay, we can save here. I do consider this to be very, very solid run. We did everything great. I don't know if I wanna talk to Matthias. Okay, I know. We don't. Nice job, you managed to get the good number of them to join. And less of them died than if we went with our usual methods. Clued me into your mission with Matthias. Absorb into ranks. Your final prize is Amelia, the wayward daughter of Graven Ash. I don't want to enrage Horus. Maybe I fucking should. I fucking hate myself. I mean, I'm sure I will have plenty of opportunity to enrage Scarlet Horus. You just wanna go strategic with it. It's not always easy to like make right decision in situations like this. Okay, Jagged Remedy is only dialogue option here. You have a deal, give me wrapped. Perfect. Okay, this is not a notch, but it's good, good enough, like. We are very close to level. We can check journey in case of quest. Investigate sentinel stand keep. Evidence graven ash. Seals of power. Climb more spires. This is only quest we can do in this moment. And honestly, I would gladly reconsider option to getting back to Spire. Okay. Okay, I can see where we are. There is absolutely no way to go anywhere else than here. Let me know what you think about this quality drop, if this still is watchable for people who ever watch it. I should possibly continue in this garbage quality even though I hate it. Quiet down. Also, if you're asking why I would save so much, it's because I like tactical approach to combat. I like when combat can start in my terms.
Been a while since I last came to Stalwart. All that disfavored fighting led to this. You didn't see nothing.
Mm-hmm. There is a lot you can do with same assets. So, even if this location looks similar to another, I still think they made good use of it. Tyranny is not exactly high budget game. Even worse, it's in fucking Claws of Paradox. But this is probably best Obsidian CRPG they ever made. Pillars of Eternity 2 is not that good. And Pillars of Eternity 2 is great.
Sorry, I can't. Can't do that.
This game is literally perfect, like maybe not perfect, but within the lore skill spectrum of playing, it's great. Because you can invent your own spells. If you could invent your own moves and have same system for athletics as you have for lore, game would be extremely good. This is basically only reason why I go quad mage. Well, not now, since Verse is able to talk a lot. My mission right now is to investigate this place, right? Okay, let's see where I should go. Okay, we go there. This place is extremely fucking hard to see anything always, but at night it's even fucking worse. Also, I remember having something like Stalwart Insignia in past, so we're just making sure I don't have this item now. Just in fucking case. I don't see anything like this in my inventory, so we might be safe to say I don't. Okay. Okay, this dagger is always better. For the drivers, at least. This thing is not better because recovery accuracy, but armor penetration. Okay, since this dagger is much better for this. That basically leaves me with no choice. I don't know where is parry stat. Okay, this does increase parry by 4. But we can no longer afford it. This dagger is too good. This object gives tranquility. However, none of my character currently benefit from wearing it. I mean tenacity, I'm sorry, tenacity. Yes, this scroll also gives tenacity. I should possibly consider the wait. Nothing. Never mind. I'm sadly not very familiar with this place, so.
Look here. You didn't see nothing.
We only wanna like explore it a little. According to my knowledge, you need something like stalwart insignia that will basically help you get through this. I wanna be in sneak mode if we start going for combat or something like this. It's because I'm way stronger. When I am first one to move or have initiative. Yeah, this is the entry. Why they name him Brown Bottom? The fuck? Okay, I like it for prank value. I know this is not very mature. Why Brown Butler? Initiation rites were severe. Jack tremendously makes sure that his new recruits are too degraded and spoiled for another gang to want them. I'm nearly sure he made. I'm sorry. I mean, he's pretty badass, to be honest. Like, being able to sacrifice his own pride for his own people and country is pretty strong. So, you know, I mean, I can make fun of good writing, but I can admire his sacrifice. So when I was with my dear friend Scarlet Horus. Oh fuck, oh fuck, oh fuck. Oh shit, oh fuck. I don't wanna fight them, no. Please. First of all, these are very powerful spirit. My FPSs don't really support combat like this. Wait, this is misplay or miscast, rather. Honestly, I consider going here. Okay, I consider going here with use of my power swap position with Vers. I will show you. This would be rather double heal because Vers heal me and I heal myself. Okay, this will be game changer if I cast it. Yeah, my FPSs are trash, but... Honestly, game is still great. And I will be glad if I will be able to continue playing it. Okay. Honestly, I might cast healing spell because right now is the best option. He might also wanna cast healing spell. Okay, you need to check how much HP you have. Okay, everyone is full. There is Janos. Why I'm here is none of your concern. Why are you here? Tell me about this Regan Herloms. How they can help us? Why are you not going? 5. Now we unlock the Rust Canyon. Locate the Unbroken, and we need this stupid insignia to basically open the path there. These insignia are extremely powerful. They give like 3 or 2 resolve, which increase your lore skill when you wear them. And they are obviously key item when you craft the best spell. And yes, we will be using them a lot. So thanks to boots you have tenacity, you will have vit in scroll, or plus 10 lore in personal items for some of these clowns, and we'll see. Honestly, I wanna check if this is 180. Yes. Most of his abilities are 180. So there is absolutely nothing to, you know, to talk about. This is max. I don't know how you lock camera on character, but that doesn't matter really. What is matter is that we basically cleared 2 locations today. And I would call it episode, honestly. I'm more than surprised that I was able to record that in 30 frames. I mean, I knew this will be mostly CPU related, not GPU, and I will be able to do that. But it's still impressive. Thanks for watching.